Yes, welcome dear students. As earlier I have provided you the notes regarding the cell cycle and cell division. Now today I am providing you the details regarding the cell cycle. When we move toward the cell cycle, it means that one is the divide, grow and re-divide. So the new cells at the end of mitosis are relatively small with a full size nucleus but relatively little cytoplasm. And when we move towards the cell cycle, first one is the interphase. The interphase stage itself has three phases. First one is the first growth phase. What are the changes take place in the first growth phase? That one is RNA and protein are synthesized. The volume of the cytoplasm increases. Mitochondria and chloroplast divide. It means when we talk about the chloroplast, it means in plant cell only, not in animal cell. Chloroplast is not present in the animal cell. Then after, it goes towards the S phase. S phase, that one is the second phase of the interphase. That one, S phase, is the synthesis phase. Synthesis phase, what happened in that case? Here, more DNA is synthesized and the chromosomes are duplicated. When the chromosomes are duplicated here, after that, it moves towards the third phase of the third stage of the interphase. That one is the second growth phase. Second growth phase, it is a shorter growth phase, and in that case the RNA and protein which is necessary for cell division, they continually synthesized in the second growth phase, and then cell is ready to start next cell division. It means it goes toward the mitotic division, which starts from first phase. That one is the prophase. So before mitotic division, before phases of mitosis, earlier it was the phase of interphase. Now when the interphase has completed, then the phases of mitosis which include the karyokinesis. Karyokinesis of mitosis occur in four main phases. Number one, prophase. What are the changes take place in prophase? When you look towards the diagrams, when you look towards the pictures of the different stages of cell cycle, which earlier I have provided you in the previous notes, you look toward the picture, then you are able to recognize what are the changes take place in the prophase. Centriole, it starts moving apart and reaching opposite poles. In the early prophase, you have seen centriole starts moving apart, and up to the late prophase, they reach on the opposite poles. Now, next change, what are these? Chromosome become distinct. Earlier in the interphase, you people have seen chromosomes, they are in the form of chromatin threads. Chromatin threads in the interphase, which is known as the resting phase. Then when it starts move toward the mitotic phase, that one first stage is the prophase. Here these chromatin threads, they condensed and then converted into the form of the chromosomes. Chromosomes, center part of the chromosome, that one is known as the centromere, through which that both the arms of the chromosomes are be attached together. These arms are known as the chromatid. And when you look toward the different changes, what are these? Firstly, centriole start moving apart and reach opposite poles. Chromosome become distinct. Chromosomes duplicated as paired chromatids. Then spindle fibers appear daughter centriole, between daughter centriole, and the nuclear membrane and nucleolus disappear. You people have seen around the chromosome one nuclear membrane is be there, dotted structure, that it starts getting disappear at the late prophase. Then when you move toward the second stage, that one is the metaphase. Here you people have seen that nuclear membrane and nucleolus, it disappear, fully disappear, no appearance of the nuclear membrane is be here. Now what happened in the case of the metaphase? Here the chromosomes that get attached to spindle by its centromere. Centromere, what is that centromere? It is the rounded structure through which the different arms of the chromosomes are attached together. Okay, these get is attached at the spindle. Then chromosome, they lined up in one plane. You people have seen in the picture also the chromosome, they get lined up at equator in a one plane. These are the changes which take place in the metaphase stage. Now that one, next one, that one is the anaphase. What you have seen in anaphase? Anaphase, you people have seen centromere attaching the two chromatids, they starts divide. The chromosomes which are lined up in one plane, they start dividing from the centromere in the anaphase. And these two sister chromatids, they start separating from the centromere and drawn apart towards opposite poles. Drawn towards the opposite poles. And up to the late anaphase, you people have seen in the diagram, a furrow starts in the cell membrane at the middle in the animal cell. In the animal cell, the furrow formation is be there. You people have seen. And then next one is the telophase. That is, in this stage, you people have seen two sets of daughter chromosomes reach opposite poles. These are the two daughter cell chromosome, set of daughter chromosome, they reach opposite poles. And here you people have seen spindle fibers, they get disappear. And again, what are the changes? The nuclear membrane, which starts disappearing in the prophase stage, it again formed in the telophase. Again, the nuclear membrane is formed. Nucleoli reappear in this phase. So these all are the stages of the karyokinesis. It means the division of the nucleus. Now all these are the stages. After that, cytokinesis, where the division of the cytoplasm take place. Here you people have seen cleavage furrow deepens totally in the daughter cell. Totally in animal cell. And here what happened? It separates the two daughter cells. The formation of the daughter cell take place. So in these stages, the whole phase of mitosis take place. Again, lastly, I am telling you, first interphase, then here interphase is divided into three. That one is the, what are these? F, first growth phase, that one is G1, then synthesis phase, S, then second growth phase, G2. Okay, that one interphase, then prophase, metaphase, anaphase, telophase, and lastly cytokinesis, where the two daughter cells get formed. So all these are the different stages of the mitosis. Now I am sure about that ki you people are not getting any confusion regarding the different stages of mitosis. Earlier I already provided you the notes regarding that. So now thank you students, and please go through these notes which I have given you, as well as the material which I have provided you in the audio form. And again, if you have getting any confusion, please provide the different things, whichever, wherever you get the confusion, I will solve all the problems of you. Thank you. Go through the audio as well as the notes which I have provided you from this part, that one is the cell division. Thank you.